Okay, this is gonna break your brain just a little bit, but this right here is an IP address. What? Yeah, no, it is. But you're probably thinking, Chuck, no, IP addresses look like this. And sure, you're right. But this right here is how your computer, how all computers see your IP address. It's like putting on some special glasses and seeing the code in the matrix. This is your IP address in the matrix. So, get your coffee ready. We're about to get jacked in to the matrix. That's how you say it, right? Yeah, let's go. So here is an IP address. This might be your IP address. And if you watch the previous episodes in this series, this looks familiar. This is nice and fuzzy. Four numbers, four octets, separated by three dots. But then we just put on our matrix glasses. We're seeing this IP address in computer code. This is referred to as binary, the language of computers. Now, if we look back at the previous version, let me switch it back. This we refer to as decimal, and this as binary. Our goal in this video is to understand first what the junk is happening with this binary. What even is this? And second, we're gonna learn the magic. What I just showed you, yeah, check that out. That's cool, right? Let's do it again. You're gonna learn how to do that. We're gonna learn how to convert from decimal to binary and then binary to decimal. Now, you're probably thinking, why? Like, why is it so important that I need to see the matrix code of my IP addresses? Well, honestly, this is kind of a wax on, wax off scenario. Learning this skill right here is going to help you do something later. This is essential to doing subnetting, because right now you suck at it and we want to change that. So in this video, just think, this is going to help me subnet. I am going to become a decimal to binary conversion ninja. Or getting back to our analogy, you're the one, you are Neo. You can see the code going through the air, you know. So let's make that happen right now. So here we go, take one more sip of coffee. We're gonna dive deep here. And trust me, once you learn this, it's kind of fun to do. Kind of fun, no, it's really fun. That, I'm gonna leave it there. But before I show you how to do this, let's talk about what's even going on here. We know this is binary, but, huh? What does that even mean? Now, first, what I want you to do is count how many numbers there are here, how many digits. Go ahead and count right now. I'll wait, pause the video. Unpause. How many were there? 25, right? No, wrong, 32. 32 numbers here, right? Or we could also say 32 bits. What does that mean? Well, you see, in computers and in the matrix, everything has a size, right? Like this video I'm recording right now, it's 4K, it will likely be about 60 gigabytes, right, Nick? Yeah. This picture of Bernard Hackwell is about 10 megabytes. And this text file I just created is 29 bytes. Now, you probably noticed that I'm going down in size, right? Going from gigabytes to megabytes. I know I skipped kilobytes, relax. All the way down to bytes, big to small, right? You got it. But we can go even lower, even smaller than bytes. You probably saw where this is coming. We can go from bytes to bits. And that's what we're seeing here. Each of these numbers, these digits, are bits. The ground floor, as low as we can go as far as size in computers goes. Go. Let me ask you a question. You might already know this. How many bits make up a byte? Pause the video. Comment below. Unpause. If you guessed 8, you're right. 8 bits make 1 byte. So if I were to ask you, how big is an IP address in bits? You might say, how many? 32 bits. And then I might ask you, hey, how big is an IP address in bytes? What would you say? 4, right? Notice how each of our octets is 8 bits. We have 4 octets at 8 bits each. 8 times 4, 32. So to sum this up, as you're looking at this binary number, what you're actually looking at is the lowest level of storage in a computer, the lowest size, the raw data. And we just discovered why we call these sections between the dots octets. Well, because octo, 8, they're 8 bits. Octo, octets, there you go, octopets, octets. I don't know why I said that. So IP addresses, 32 bits, that's cool. But now let's talk about what are these numbers even doing? Like, I don't see a lot of number diversity here. All I see are ones and zeros. And the reason is that's just what binary is, ones and zeros. And that's frankly all your computer cares about, one and zero. But it's more than just like one and zero. It's what the one and zero are communicating to the computer. You see, one indicates on and zero indicates off. That's literally what it means. It's like a light switch, on, off, like Nosferatu. Nosferatu can speak binary and he's communicating with the computer, hey, off, on, no, on, off, like legit, think about this, on, off, off, off. And by doing that, we're communicating something to the computer. And you're probably thinking, what? What is he even doing? What does on and off have to do with this number and IP addresses? This. I'm about to show you something. It's gonna get a little weird, but just hang tight with me. It will all make sense here in a moment. This is where it happens. You're about to learn how to take the matrix code of IP addresses and convert them back into decimal. We're gonna convert this IP address back to what we know and love, decimal. So here we go, coffee break. Let's get weird. I'm gonna start writing some random numbers. Hang tight with me. 1, 2, and I'm writing them backwards, right? 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128. This right here, our little chart, is gonna save your life. This is our powers of two chart. And it's the secret sauce. It's our secret decoder ring to convert from matrix to regular stuff. Now, what do I mean by powers of two? Well, I mean this. The first number is 2 to the power of 0. If we get our handy dandy calculator out, 2 to the power of 0 is 1. That matches. Then we have 2 to the power of 1, which is 2. Now you kind of see where I'm going with this. The next thing will be 2 to the power of 2, and so on and so on. Now this will make sense here in a moment, but I want you to remember how to build this chart. You can actually do it two ways. One is this way, they get the powers of 2. Start with 0. 2 to the power of 0 is 1. And go all the way until you get to 2 of the power of 7, which is 8 digits total, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The power of 2's table. It's our secret power. Or you can just start with 1 and multiply by 2 each time. So 1 times 2 is 2. 2 times 2 is 4. 4 times 2 is 8. 8 times 2 is 16. 16 times, you know, you got it, right? Either way, you want to build this amazing chart right here. Why? Because watch this, the magic is about to happen. Whoa, pause. You've been working hard, you've been learning a lot. So let's take a quick coffee break and talk about today's sponsor, SafeDNS. Now, I'm not sure if you knew this, but the biggest threat to your network, whether it's your home or your business, is you. And it's your family, and it's your coworkers. It's their fault. From accessing questionable websites that can compromise your security, whether it's your home or your business, to accessing time-wasting websites, and really websites no one should be looking at. Like your kids. What are your kids looking at? They're curious, man. You gotta block some stuff. And if your network's kind of like the Wild West, where people can just access whatever they want, that is your biggest security weakness. So how do we protect you from you? That's where our sponsor comes in, SafeDNS. SafeDNS is a cloud-based DNS filter that's ridiculously easy to get set up and installed. And also, once installed, it just kind of sits there and does its thing. You don't have to worry about it. Set it and forget it, saving you money and time. You can set up SafeDNS to cover your entire network by using your router, or you can install a SafeDNS agent on individual devices. Well, let me show you. Once set up, SafeDNS will use machine learning and AI to block stuff based on categories that you set. So check it out here in the dashboard. I can jump over to categories and I can choose from 61 individual categories, ranging from cybersecurity stuff to illegal activity to just time wasters and general crap that maybe you don't want your people to see or use or access. They also have compliance with regulations like the CIPA, BPJM, and others, including Project Arachnid. They actually receive child abuse image content list from the Internet Watch Foundation. And if you do want to allow or deny things outside those categories, you can do that right here. Allow list. Things like networkchuck.coffee. Delicious. And deny stuff, like maybe ground your kids or protect your coworkers from crappy coffee. And if they do try to access these sites, they will get blocked, protecting them from malicious coffee attacks or dating websites, because my daughters are not ready to date yet, nor will they ever be. And looking at our settings, we have a ton of options. Here, I can define separate policies, define schedules for those policies, and do advanced things like forcing safe search and forcing restricted mode for YouTube. I can do custom block pages, as you saw that I had earlier, and even add aliases, custom DNS record entries for your host, which is super powerful. And of course, when you want to geek out, they have all the stats. Going up here to stats, and just looking at today, I can see all the requests coming in, all the blocks, all the categories my family's been accessing, the domains they're visiting. And to go more granular, of course, I can go detailed right here, where I can export reports and get some cool data. And also, SafeDNS has lightning fast support, replying to your chats within like 2 minutes. Actually, let's see if they'll do it. Live test. So if you're ready to protect your house, your kids, your company, check out SafeDNS, link below. Use the codes here on the screen or below, and you'll get 2 months free, either for home or for business. And look, they're already typing. That was under a minute, so I wasn't lying. For this next part, we're gonna bring back in Nosferatu to help us. And what I mean is we're gonna take this first octet over here and write it out. Notice how there are 8 bits or 8 numbers in our first octet, and there are also 8 numbers we wrote down in our chart. Let's match them up. So 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Now here we go, Nosferatu, are you ready? Remember, 1 means on, 0 means off. Now here we go, the first number, 128. Is it off or on? It's on, so let's write it down, 128. The second number, 64, is it on or off? It's on, 1 means on, thanks Nosferatu, 64. The rest, they're all zeros, they're off. Nosferatu, flick the light, so 0, 0, 0, 0. So none of these numbers are gonna carry down. So all the rest of the numbers are off, we don't need them. Now here's what I want you to do, and this, again, still feels weird, I know. I want you to add the numbers that were on together. 128 plus 64 gives us 192. This right here, it's a big moment for you, because Right here, we just converted our first octet from matrix code, from binary to decimal. Legit, that's what we did. This number right here is 192 and decimal. That's kind of cool, right? Let's do our next one. Let's bring our next octet down, line up our numbers. 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0. And with the help of Nosferatu, let's see what carries over. Let's see what's turned on and what's turned off. We've got 128. Nope, no 64. 32, we got that sucker. No 16, we do have an 8. No 4, no 2, no 1. So we're left with 128 and 32 and 8. Now let's add those together. 128 plus 32 is 160, and then 160 plus 8 is 168. So the second octet in decimal is 168. Now it's starting to look familiar, isn't it? Now I'm starting to see the IP address the way we learned it. Let's do it again, but faster. Our third octet. In fact, I want you to do this by yourself. So pause the video and see if you can do this. Write this down, and with the help of Nosferatu, I know you can do it. Pause the video. Unpause. Let's walk through it real quick. Let's bring down our binary. 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. The only number that's turned on is the last one. We got ourselves a 1, and 1 plus nothing else is 1. And that's the next number in our IP address. That's what this octet means. And finally, the last one. Bring that sucker down. Match up our binary to our chart. 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. That was a lot. Nosferatu, help us out. We'll bring down our 16. Bring down our 4. Bring down our 1. 16 plus 4 is 20. Plus 1 is 21. Guys, that's it. That's our IP address. We just converted our IP address from matrix code, from binary to decimal. How cool is that? If you don't think that's cool, I don't know what to tell you. Drink some more coffee, rewind, watch it again. Coffee's a bit cold already. I need to warm it up. Okay, now let's switch it up. Let's do it in reverse. Let's take an IP address in decimal format, the way we know and love, and let's convert that to matrix code. Huh, how do you do that? Well, with the same chart, guys. It's easy. We already have the magic decoder translation here. Here's our IP address in decimal format. Let's convert the sucker to matrix code to binary. Like always, we'll start with our first octet. We got 172 here. Now don't worry, we are still gonna use Nosferatu. He's standing by, he's ready. But it is gonna be a bit different here. So here's what we'll do. We'll bring down 172 right next to 128. And we'll say, hey, can we take 128 away from 172? Are we able to subtract 128 from 172? The answer is yeah, we can. And because we can, that means this one is on. Nosferatu, help us out. 128 is on 1. Not for a little bit of math, we'll do it up here. 172 minus 128. A little bit of math, 12 minus 8, we got 4. 6 minus 2, we got 4. Cool, so now we have 44 left over. So 172 minus 128 is 44. We have 44 left over. So now what we'll do is we'll take this 44 over here and go, hey, can 44 have 64 taken away from it? No, it can't. So Nosferatu, help us out. 64 is going to be off, 0. And then we'll keep going down the line. Hey, can 44 have 32 taken away from it? Heck yeah, it can. It totally does. So Nosferatu, help us out. 32 is gonna be on. 44 minus 32, we got 12 left. Can we take 16 away from 12? No, right? I think you're seeing the pattern here. Nosferatu, help us out. It's gonna be turned off. We don't need 16. Let's move down the line. Can we take 8 away from 12? Heck yeah, we can. Let's do that. We got 4 left over. Oh, we forgot to make 8 on. There we go. Let's move on down the line. Can 4 have 4 taken away from it? Totally can. Nosferatu, turn it on. And then if we do our math, this one's an easy one. 4 minus 4, we got 0. And because 0 can't have 2 taken away from it or 0 taken away from it, then the last two bits here are going to be turned off. 0 and 0. Thanks for the help, Nosferatu. So what we just did, look at the bottom here. 101, 01100. We just converted the number 172 to binary. Now I want you to try the next one. Try the next octet, which is 16. Pause the video, see what you got. Unpause. Now here, I'll walk through it real quick, and you might be surprised that this one is kind of quick. Because if we take 16, we go to the first one, hey, can't take 128 from it, can't take 64 from it, can't take 32 from it. So right off the bat, Nosferatu already knows, and he'll help us do this, that those have to be turned off. But when we get to 16, dude, heck yeah, we can take 16 away from 16. Let's turn that bit on. Thanks, Nosferatu. And then with some math magic, 16 minus 16, we got 0. And then going down the line, can you take 8 away from 0? Nope. 4, turn it off. 2, no, turn it off. 1, no, turn it off. At 16, the rest of the bits will be turned off because we can't subtract anymore, we're done. And we just converted the number 16 to binary, to matrix code. So now, go ahead, pause the video and try the next two octets, or the last two octets, 34 and 3, go. Unpause. Let's walk through it real quick. So, the third octet, we got 34. Can 128 be taken away from 34? No. About 64? No. 32? Heck yeah. 34 minus 32, we got 2. So 16 is 0, 8 is 0, 4 is 0, but 2 can be taken away from 0. That's gonna be a 1. And then now that we have 0, it's turned off. Bam! There is our third octet. And then finally, the number 3. Can 128 be taken away from 3? No, it's turned off. Nosferatu, help us out. 64? No. 32? No. 16? No. 8? No. 4? Not even 4? No. But 2? Hey, 3 minus 2, we got that. So let's turn two on, three minus two is one. Can one be taken away from one? 100%, that's gonna be turned on, and we're done. That is our number in binary, three in binary. And there it is, we did it. Using our magic decoder ring, our fancy handy dandy chart, we converted decimal back into binary. Okay, take yourself a sip of coffee. That was a lot. You just learned how to decode the matrix for your IP address anyway. We saw the IP address the way our computers see it. Binary, 32 bits of matrix code. And we converted that matrix code back into a decimal format, the way we like to read it. And then, sucker, we put that back into binary. Now this is a skill that you need to hone and learn and practice and solidify, cement into your brain. Because this is one of those building blocks. This is leg day. This is what you need, don't skip it, to be able to become a subnetting master. But don't worry, because all you need is this chart right here, our super secret decoder ring that will help us convert from binary to decimal and decimal to binary. Now don't worry, if you're like, man, that was a lot, that's kind of heavy. That's fine. Go back and rewatch the video. When I first learned this, it took me a bit. And honestly, to like really get that going in your brain, you gotta practice it. So if you do want some extra practice, I will have some below at Network Chuck Academy, so check it out. And also, hey, have you hacked the YouTube algorithm today? Let's make sure you do. Hit that like button, notification bell, comment, subscribe. You gotta hack YouTube today. Ethically, of course. Okay, here we go, fair warning. This is not gonna be for little ears. Or if you're airing this episode to a classroom, you might wanna turn it off at this point. Because we're gonna talk about something that you don't have covered yet. Now I know, you've got decimal to binary and binary to decimal conversion covered. But you know what you don't have covered? Your butt, your balls, and your body. It's so awkward to say. But you know who does have it covered? Our sponsor, Manscaped. Manscaped is going beyond the groin, which is so awkward to say, with a brand new lineup of men's products called the Manscaped Ultra Premium Collection. Ultra Premium Awesome, they couldn't include any more words there. Now legit, I've been using this every day, and I love it. It's awesome, I'm not even kidding. This is an all-in-one skin and hair kit for the everyday man and covers you from head to toe. And they do this thing where it's like a 5 steps in 5 minutes thing, like again, it covers you from head to toe. Because you gotta take care of yourself. So let me show you the steps. And I apologize in advance, you're about to see me get in the shower. And this is just what's happening right now. Step one, you get in the shower and you put in some shampoo into your hair. It's infused with coconut water, green tea, aloe, turmeric. This non-greasy formula is naturally hydrating and rich in antioxidants to revitalize the look and feel of your hair. It also smells pretty freaking good. My wife likes it. Step two, once your hair is rinsed, pump the Manscaped body wash into your washcloth or loofah and scrub your entire body. Vigorously. Body wash also has stuff in it, like aloe and sea salt. It also smells good and makes your skin feel good. And once you're all washed and rinsed, get out of the shower. Towel off and you're not done yet. You gotta moisturize. But I don't have time to sit there and lotion all over my body. No, they got a 360 degree hydrating spray, which actually is, I use it legit every day. It'll moisturize all those hard to reach areas. And then step four, of course, you need deodorant because you're gonna stink. You're going to, so please use deodorant, please. This stuff is aluminum free, stain free, and dries clear. And like everything so far, it smells pretty stinking good. And finally, step five, you probably can't see this because my mustache is covering it, but you wanna apply some lip balm. It actually has vitamin E and peppermint and eucalyptus to help soothe, hydrate, and seal in moisture. And boom, that's it. 5 steps in 5 minutes. And all that stuff you just used is cruelty free, paraben free, and vegan, so you can. No, don't eat it. Don't eat it. No, I'm still using the products they sent me, but I'll probably do this. They have a Manscaped peak hygiene plan, so you can make sure you never run out of the products, which surprisingly, I still have not run out because that stuff lasts a long time. But I'm gonna go ahead and do this too, so you should do it. You can pick a replenishment cycle that will, you know, recycle and replenish your stuff when you need to get some more, and it's delivered right to your door. No stress. So go to manscaped.com and use code NETWORKCHUCK and you'll get 20% off. When you just use the link below, and you get free international shipping, which is kind of crazy. So again, in case you didn't hear me, you need to clean out your ears with some Manscaped products, that's 20% off with the code NETWORKCHUCK and free international shipping. So thank you, Manscaped, for making me feel super awkward on camera and for sponsoring this video. Please go, don't let this be in vain. Buy their stuff. Okay, bye.